Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hey there, in this video we are going to use Illustrator to make this kind of like semi-flat design. We use these icons on the left to get started, then we'll do some more interesting things with the app design on the right. Cool, let's go and learn how to do that now in Adobe Illustrator. Alright, first up, open up the icons document in your exercise files. And what we're going to do is we're not going to kind of 3D rotate them at the same time as these guys. We want these to have an extrude depth. But we want these guys just to kind of plaster to the top. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to select all these circles so I can hold shift and keep clicking. Okay, so I'm going to do that. And I've got them all selected because what we've got to decide now is the effect that you want. Okay, so if I go to Effect 3D and go to Extrude and Bevel, when they're not grouped, turn Preview on, what ends up happening is these guys rotate, but kind of irrespective of the kind of total group. Okay, let's have a little look. Let's rotate this around. See, they're just kind of doing their own thing. So I'm going to do a little screenshot here so that you can see what I mean. Because if I hit cancel and say I'm going to group them first and go to effect. Actually, I'll bring in that graphic. Where's my screenshot? We could use the magic of editing, Dan. No, must do it all here. Okay, so I've got this background. I've grouped it. So the difference is if I go to 3D and I go to extrude and bevel. And I do the exact same thing to preview on. Can you see they are now, there's more of an isometric group. Okay, if I rotate you around, can you see they kind of know where each other are in the world, whereas these are all individual. Hopefully you get the idea. Cool, so decide where you want to do it, okay, where you want these things to lay down, decide on the depth. Okay, I'm gonna have mine quite thin and try and avoid looking at all the random circles everywhere. Kind of try and steer through them. Cool, so once you've got it kind of how you want, you can decide as well. At the moment I'm going for this kind of like linear, flat, semi-flat, isometric kind of drawing, okay, where there's no perspective. So you could though go into here and say, actually I want perspective and crank it up. So there's this kind of like fold depth. You can play around with the lighting as well and how this works. But at the moment I'm going to turn off the perspective, okay, and have them like this. Cool, I move my back to the top. Great, so we're kind of there. Now we need to do the same thing with the icons, but the icons use a different mode, okay, so they're not using extrude. But what we do need to do is remember these angles. So I'm going to take a screenshot of this again using my, if you're on a Mac, it's Command Shift and 4. You can drag a box around it and it ends up on your desktop. On a PC, I think it's just print screen. You can just paste it into Illustrator. Either way, let's click OK. And we need to make sure that these guys are grouped as well. Okay, if you've grouped the background. Okay, so we've grouped the circles. So we also need to group the icons, which I've already done for you. So the slight different effect is Effect 3D. We're gonna use Rotate. Turn Preview on. Okay, and all we need to do is match what we had before. And I didn't bring in that extra screenshot. Let's go, screenshot. Come. New Effect. 3D revolve, rotate. Come, preview on and just type out these. This one's 36 minus 35, 18. If you had perspective, which we don't, you can match that as well. I'm gonna click OK. You can see now they match the background stuff. What we might have to do is just a little adjustment to get them right in the center there. Cool, that's how to do semi-flat icons. Now, what I'll quickly do though is we'll do a shadow on it and then we'll get into that thing you saw at the beginning with the application. So skip ahead if you don't want to learn how to do a shadow. So what we're going to do is I just want the circles. I'm going to make a duplicate of it because I don't want, we're going to fake a shadow. Okay, you could use a drop shadow tool and I never get good success with that. So effects stylized shadow if you want to do that. What I'm going to do is first of all expand these because they're driving me mad. So object, expand appearance. And now I want to join them all up. And to join them all up, we need to make sure they're not grouped. So I'm going to click off in the background and you are all grouped. So I'm going to right click, ungroup. Yep, they're ungrouped. These guys are grouped. So I'm going to select them all, ungroup them again. What are we left with? Okay, and now it's a kind of a testing. So they're all ungrouped. I know this is probably not gonna work. So grab my shape builder tool and drag a box around them all. And it's meant to join them all. If it doesn't do that, it just means some of the parts, like this guy here, is right click, release clipping mask. There's some 3D ends up with some artifacts. Okay, so I've got all these guys. If you're doing it with squares, I tested this before, it didn't have this problem. Just release clipping mask. You might have to do some ungrouping, releasing clipping mask. Okay, now I've got them all. Shape builder tool. Fill color, I'm gonna pick black. I'm gonna hold the shift key down and it just drags over them all. And hopefully it's gonna stand them into one giant thing. Cool, so now what I wanna do, I'm gonna group them just for no good reason. Grab the right tool, okay, the black arrow. I'm gonna put them just underneath. This is what I'm doing for shadows. And with them selected, I'm gonna effect, I'm gonna go to blur, I'm gonna go to Gaussian blur. Turn preview on and just adjust this radius until you feel happy. It's gonna be too dark to start with. I want a kind of a light one there. Cool. And you can either play with the fill color or the opacity and just turn it down so it mixes with the background. What you also might do is play around with under opacity, under these layer modes, you might find one of these that works better with the thing underneath. Ours is gonna work just fine under normal because we have a really flat background color. How much do we like those? Ooh, I'm not sure. I'm gonna try and find these guys. But you don't mind, you just want to get on to the next bit. Let's get on to the next one. Okay, and the next one is I've made an artboard. I've kept it quite far apart from the first one just because when we're flipping things around, we need a bit of extra room. We're gonna bring in the app mockups. Now I mock these up in a program called Adobe XD. Okay, you can mock them up in Illustrator or Photoshop, it doesn't matter. But I've done this job, now I wanna kind of make this isometric lay down thing. So I'm gonna bring in all four images. It's in your exercise files under XD mockup. Bring them in, click once, twice, three times, four times, okay. Now, black arrow, click off. I want you, I'll use him later on. And these three guys I would like to lay out now. I use my shortcut, remember, selecting all of these, command function F12 is my distribute these centers. And yeah, cool. So to get started, I want to group these because I want them to be kind of operating together. I'm going to go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel, to the preview on. Now, this is because we're using images now and not just vector, it is going to freak out your computer a bit. So if you're finding it really slow, you might have to go and close down every program you can to kind of try and facilitate this. So I'm rotating around. I'm going to add a little bit of perspective in this one. How much? In there, just using my up arrow. Little bit of perspective. See, it's taking its while to catch up because it is. I'm just going to type it in. I'm trying to record using screen capture software as well, which is stressing everything out. 3D, it's all going nuts. So that's all I really want to do. A little bit of perspective, and yeah, get the angles how you want them. I'm not sure I'm happy with them yet. Yeah, that looks good. Except I want more perspective. All right, so let's click OK. So next thing to do is either drop shadows. We might as well do the drop shadows now before we do this thing. It's essentially the same as this first style. I'll show you a couple of extra tricks as we go. Yeah, it's worth hanging around for. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate these guys. Okay, so make, oh, sorry. Duplicate these guys, so I've got an extra copy. Get that guy out of the way. And we're gonna remember exactly like we did before. We're gonna go to Object, Expand Appearance. So they're no longer editable 3D. And what we'll also do is right click, ungroup, because we wanna use the same trick as we did before. I'm right clicking, ungrouping. There's probably gonna be some tricks we need to do. I've ungrouped them a few times. Let's give it a whirl. Let's go to Shape Builder tool, hold Shift and say, all of you fellas, join up. And all of them did except for the one I didn't select. Okay, awesome. All right, so they're all this. I'm going to give them all a fill color of black. And what we're going to do is, there are some bits underneath. It's kind of weird when you're working 3D, there's all sorts of clipping masks and bits going on. I don't need you, I just want you three. I'm gonna group them and then I'm gonna go to my cheap drop shadow trick effect.
blur, Gaussian blur, preview. Yeah, that works for me. Cool. And I'm going to stick them underneath. And what I'll do is I'll lower the opacity in a second once we get the other image underneath. So now this guy, I need to work out what angle to put him on. I didn't take a screenshot, so I can go back in, select it, click on 3D Extrude and Bevel. Now, screenshot. If I'll place that screenshot. You're thinking, it better be worth me hanging around because it's the same thing over. Kind of is. There's a gem at the end, I promise. Skip to the end. Okay, so we're going to go to Effect. We're going to go to, not that one, Effect, 3D, and we're going to go to Rotate. And in here, we're going to copy. So 59 minus 26, 8, and the perspective was 25. I'll leave preview off, stop it freaking out when it's trying to adjust it. All right, you have done your job, and you should be the same perspective as this stuff. And what I might do is just scale it up. So it kind of, I'm going to crop it at the end. Scaling it up freaks it out. Okay. All right. If you're wondering how to speed up, if you're doing a lot of this, okay, there's a whole video series on how to speed up Illustrator. In this case, it's going to be Effect Rasterize Settings. That will, at the moment, we're doing it too high at 300 dpi, but I'm just dealing with it. All right, I'm going to push this to the back. Okay, and what I might do with this is I'm going to crop it all out in a second. There's a couple of things I want to do. One is I want to move these guys so they're kind of just off screen. So you plus, it's a little hard to grab. So you fellas, I want to be a little bit bigger. Prepare for freaking out. Scaling is the worst offender. I want to come off. It's really even hard to see my artboard now. But I want this kind of effect. You saw it at the beginning. Oh, my shadows. Okay, so a couple of things we didn't do. One was in my shadows here, I just left, so I'm trying to get a hold of my shadows here underneath. There they are, cool. So I'm gonna lower the opacity, or you can go, because there's something underneath it now, we can go to opacity and have a look at some of the blending modes. Okay, soft light's probably gonna work. Cool, maybe not what I wanted, overlay. Dan, you should have practiced this first. I'm going to go back to normal and just turn the opacity down. Yeah, that looks good. Cool. So you're waiting for the secret trick. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a big rectangle out the back here. I'm going to lower the opacity because I want this background image to be not as strong as these. So I'm going to send it backwards until... I've kind of, maybe it's a bit too dark now. If I've lost you with this 3D mess here, it's okay, I'm a little lost myself. But basically I wanted this gray box to make this big shape of the background just a bit darker so that these apps, which are the kind of focus, seem a bit more in focus. We'll speed this up. Moving, hates it. So the trick that I've was holding out to the end here is a kind of a nice trick when you've got really busy stuff here. We're all confused, what's masked, what's not. I want to just clip it down to the artboard. So there's a cool trick in Illustrator. If I draw a box the same shape as my artboard, okay. Yeah, it was pretty close. And if we go to our layers panel, what we'll do is we'll select everything on this artboard here and we'll put it on its own layer. So I'm gonna make a new layer. I'm going to drag this little blue dot to the green dot, and now they're on layer 3. Let's lock this old layer. Okay, that's these guys that we're working on over here. Now, if I twirl down this layer and I make sure that new rectangle I drew is on the top, he already is. Okay, he's on the top. If he's not, just drag him up. And the cool thing about it is if you click the word layer 3, you don't click anything else, click layer 3, and there's an option here that says make clipping mask. This does a cool thing where it makes everything on that layer, it takes the first object and turns it into a clipping mask. Okay, my box wasn't quite ready there, but this might be something, it's quite useful because you might have seen this in, you know, well, it, what's really nice is, look, they're all still kind of individual in there. So I can grab the shadows and the background here. I'm not going to move it because that thing there takes forever to move around. But they're all kind of just hiding through this window rather than having to do it for every shape. If you're like me, you were, in the past you would have just drawn, like, you would have had five boxes and then clipping masked all the separate parts. So this way it's just a nice little extra trick. Worth waiting for? I hope so. We're here anyway. Cool. So I'm not super happy with my layout, but you're watching me the whole time, so I kind of don't get a chance to kind of stick the tongue out and go, oh, yeah, a bit more of this. And the patience with the 3D revolve, I guess, because we're videoing. I'm blaming that anyway. That's it for this one. Let's look at the, yeah, let's go on to the next video.
Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made, okay? So you're obviously doing something, don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you're, if you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, yeah, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram, and on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.